वेलकम ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ पल्स विथ मॉड्यूलेशन वेवफॉर्म बाय यूजिंग IC 3524. IC 3524 इज अ रेगुलेटिंग PWM IC. दिस IC इज हैविंग 16 पिंस. सो लेट अस टॉक अबाउट दिस IC. व्हाट आर द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ दिस IC? यूजिंग दिस IC वी कैन डिजाइन regulation power supplies as well as switching regulators. This all design is based on the single chip. High power applications can also be controlled through this device. IC 3524 is specially designed for voltage doublers without transformer coupled DC to DC converter. Their design was also related to work for switching regulators as well as polarized converters. This IC has a lot of amazing features, that is 8 milliampere standby current, a complete power control circuitry for pulse width modulation. IC 3524 has several different real life applications. Its application includes transformer coupled DC to DC converter, switching regulators of either polarity, regulating power supply, transformer-less voltage doublers, PWM techniques, and lots more. So this is how we have discussed about the IC. Now observe these pins. This pin diagram explains pin number 1 is inverting input, pin number 2 is non-inverting input, pin number 3 of this IC is oscillator output, pin number 4 and 5 are the current limiting amplifier inputs. Pin number 4 is positive and pin number 5 is negative. Pin number 6 is resistor for adjusting oscillator frequency. So we have to connect the resistor at pin number 6, and pin number 7 is capacitor for adjusting oscillator frequency. Pin number 8 is ground. Pin number 9 is compensation. Here error amplifier compensation pin is there. Then pin number 9 is device, pin number 10 is for device shutdown, pin number 11 is for emitter 1. So here BJT output 1 is there, emitter output is there. Pin number 12 is for BJT output 1, for BJT 1 collector terminal is there. Pin number 13 is for second BJT, its collector terminal is connected. Pin number 14 is for emitter 2, 15 is for VCC and 16 is for reference output. The resistor and capacitor connected at pin number 6 and 7 defines PWM frequency. The formula used for that is shown over here. The formula is PWM frequency. For calculating that formula is 1.3 divided by RT into CT. So this is the diagram for generating the PWM waveform. So here in this diagram, pin number 1 and 9 are to be shorted together. A variable resistor is to be connected at pin number 2. Pin number 3 is open circuited. Pin number 4, 5 should be connected to the ground. Pin number 8 is the ground pin. Then pin number 6 and 7, as we have discussed, we have to connect RT and CT over there. 10 is open circuited. Pin number 11 and 14 is to be connected to the ground. Pin number 12 and 13 are to be connected to the VCC by using the pull-up resistor of the fixed value. And from these two terminals, we have to take the output. Here, we will observe the two PWM waveforms. So, these are complementary. So, whenever one waveform is having on time, at that time, the other waveform is having off time. Pin number 15 is open circuited and 16 is VCC. So here on the breadboard, I have connected the circuit as shown in the diagram. So all the connections are done as per the diagram. So if we switch on the power supply, that is 12 volt. So if we switch on the power supply, we will observe the waveform on this DSO. By changing the variable resistor, we will get the different frequency. Yes, by changing this variable resistor value, we can change the duty.
दिसत नाही का वेव्ह फंक्शनल बघ बरं तुझ्यासाठी येईल का
जवळ
जवळून दिसते ना स्वतः.